In our present hurly-burly world of the easy way out, instant feedback, and microwave messages, this Christmas, with all its cherished decorations and warm memories, falling victim to the ravages of time, has that wonderful and revered holiday been shoved, condensed, mass-produced, and packaged so that it is little more than just so many reasons for another day off and overeating. Have we forgotten the true meaning of the Yuletide season, or simply replaced it with avarice for the biggest, the most, the gaudiest, and the brand name? And when you discuss that fat man that comes around only once a year, are you referring to that delinquent uncle that no one wants to feed? After all, the Bah Humbug is contagious, and its bite seems to infect more and more with each passing and unused fragrance. Maybe it's time we took a breath, put up our feet, and sang a few carols. Or maybe recall those pictures by Norman Rockwell, or paid a little more attention to It's a Wonderful Life. Yes, Virginia, that knock on the door is Santa Claus, but only if we let him in. And maybe if we quit looking into store windows, but rather into our own hearts. Can we truly quote that diminutive Timothy, with God bless us, everyone?
How lovely!
That bologna ought to sell an extra couple of hundred issues. Box it in a holly border, headline in Gothic, let's take Santa off the shelf. Use the graphic from the Santa Has to Use Tire Sale for Christmas in July as we did for the gas and yeah. I really want to tear their hearts out.
I told you they didn't believe a word of it. You owe me $5.
How can you write such moving feelings and not mean a word of it?
What do you mean not mean a word? I want you to know the Herald Tribune stands behind every word it prints.
Maybe somebody ought to carve that somewhere.
How about on my heart?
No, how about on his heart?
What's on the front page?
A photo of Santa Claus kissing children at the post office and pointing to the most wanted list. That's next to a photo of Santa opening the new discount center proclaiming Santa sleigh sale.
Which is not easy to say.
Anybody shows up in a sleigh gets 20% off.
I hate to be the street sweeper.
Where's the mayor's yearly tirade?
Oh, further down in bold-faced Cheltenham, where he thanks the public for its support for the year and hints at higher taxes in their stockings. Another philanthropist. We got that next to Cy Carlin's Corn-Fed Cafe ad proclaiming his new Catch of the Day feature.
Yeah, probably something he caught with a shovel as it ran out from under his house.
What about livestock?
What livestock?
What do we do with the picture of the two-headed turtle?
Oh, that livestock. It's next to the mayor's picture under the headline, Two Faces Are Better Than One. And I'm sure everyone will get them confused.
That's the idea. Hey, Sarah, see if you can airbrush a smile on that.
The mayor?
The turtle. That way I can say I tried to keep them separated. El Tribune what?
How do you make a turtle smile?
I don't know. I'm not married.
Oh, it wasn't in that for us all.
Baby, try to calm down, what?
What's the problem?
Something about a bond cat took fire. But lady, where are you? Highway 6.
Way out there.
Sorry, that's not in our circulation. What? Now they think I'm the fire department. Next they'll be bringing their laundry in.
You're such a citizen.
Yeah, I know. I was convicted of burning that orphanage down and they wanted to give me the chicken.
But then they decided they really wanted to publish. So they made me a newspaper publisher.
You want violins with that?
Brother, I wish I had a nickel.
Oh, you've heard this before?
No, I just wish I had a nickel.
Sarah, go out and get some shots of people shopping. You know what I mean. Smiles, badges, Christmas decorations. Hey, wait. Don't we have any shots from last year?
No, we pulled those from the morgue, remember?
Did you use some of those?
I don't think so. They're pretty old. Most of the people in them are wearing derbies and spats.
Well, do what you can. Worst comes to worst, we can always put tinsel on the turtle. Christmas is slow coming this year. Yeah, it's too bad Christmas doesn't have an animal.
Animal?
Yeah, Thanksgiving has a turkey, Easter has a bunny.
And we got you.
Hey, you want to get your Christmas bonus like last year?
Some bonus. We got 5 extra issues of the paper and an after dinner mint.
Hey, someday those issues are going to be collector's items.
Yeah, you should see the collection I have supporting the back of my couch.
Besides, I gave you those papers for a reason. I was just thinking of your parakeet.
Parakeet? I haven't had a parakeet in years. Remember that day I brought it down here and you turned on the exhaust fan?
I thought it was stuffed.
It is now.
Well, let's spread some holiday cheer around here, shall we? Delilah, where's our box of Christmas decorations?
Yeah.
I can do everything if I want to get it done. What are you still here for?
You still want those pictures?
How many times do I have to tell you? Yeah, 2 types of people that buy newspapers. Those that read them, and those who like to look at the pretty pictures.
And then there are those that like to draw horns and a mustache on your picture.
That's audience participation. And as far as I can tell, you two are the only ones that do that.
Then we're hoping it'll catch up.
Yeah, kind of like getting a weekly paycheck. Does that concept mean anything to you? Stamp your foot twice for yes.
Good. Now we'll really dress up the old sweatshop. The full panorama of Christmas tinsel lights and colors will really pick up this place.
Such is life's rich pageantry. One reindeer.
That's all we have. One lonely reindeer. What's that part of a match? That, I mean, hot dasher, hot dancer. That's 2 right there. I think there were 6 more. Not including Rudolph.
Why isn't they never called Rudolph?
This is really sad.
Sadder still. That ain't a reindeer. That's a moose.
Yeah. How'd we get a moose? Why'd we get a moose? And just how do you tell the difference between a moose and a reindeer?
Well, one jingles. And the other hangs out with the flying squirrel.
This is it? There aren't any other boxes back there?
Oh, sure. And they're all marked homicides, scandals, windows, blackmail.
What about the city council?
That's in the city council. And for Christmas, one loon box, Chief. One solitary, nearly empty box containing a masquerading moose to represent this cherished holiday which you so glowingly wrote about. And don't believe it.
I think you're dangling your participles.
Well, if you paid me more,
or at all.
I want a retraction. How dare you intimate that my newspaper is a lackey and a mouthpiece for the mayor?
Would you do that again?
I said, how dare you intimate that my newspaper is a lackey and... Wait, why'd you want me to do this again?
There was a small bug crawling by that reindeer.
A moose!
Well, we can pretend, can't we?
Oh, I hate to see him when he's all tense like this.
Oh, it's all the hustle and bustle of the holiday season.
Don't try to change the subject. My lawyer says I can sue you.
He'd say he could sue anybody. That's his job. He gets paid whether you win or lose.
I know. I hate him. But not as much as you.
Have you tried drawing horns and a mustache on his picture? It's real easy.
You really need an angle this Christmas. Some of them really grab him, yank him by the neck, nape of the neck, and make him gawk at the headlines and yell, chickens and cows!
You can take the boy out of the city.
Take one for me, too. Why don't you just all pretend I'm not here?
I thought I was doing that. Hey, why don't we take a load of presents down to the retirement center?
Not a good idea. Last week, they burned you in effigy.
But they drew horns and a mustache on you.
Were you there?
I held the torch.
You hear this? Your own staff hates you. How can you sleep with yourself?
Oh, there's a scandal. Editor-in-chief of the Herald Tribune sleeps with himself.
And we stand behind every word we print.
That wasn't anybody from the retirement center. That was a bunch of kids who flamed an old scarecrow.
But it did look like you.
Especially around the horns and mustache.
JJ, we aren't going to help anything by attacking each other. I thought we were above that sort of thing. Remember? Newspaper people, honesty, dignity. We don't need that sort of controversy. That kind of game plan.
Didn't you hear about that bonfire on Highway 4?
I told you, Highway 6! You can never get anything!
I thought that was your voice on the phone.
That was her?
And people wonder why I drink.
You don't drink!
And people wonder why I don't drink.
Come on, what else are you going to say? Come on, what was it? No more gameplay. What was that phony phone call all about? You get me out there and take pictures. Herald editor on another wild goose chase. Something like that.
I was going to say, another Christmas goose chase. Hey, can't you take a joke?
Well, maybe you wanted to get me out of town for some reason. Is that it?
You mean like how many editors does it take to screw in a light bulb? I don't know what you're talking about.
That's up. What do you know that I don't know?
Four and four are eight. Radical concept, isn't it?
If I wanted wisecracks, I'd listen to those two. Come on, what's the big idea?
A little Yuletide prank, that's all. I mean, why are you trying to read something into everything anybody does?
How many editors does it take to screw in a light bulb?
Six.
Six?
One to steal a light bulb, one to steal a chair, one to screw the ball halfway in and proclaim it doesn't work anyway, and one to shove the ball in anyway, and one has to pick it up and feel.
So how do you know that Lisa fired that bar anyway?
I was hoping you would. Then I would have shots of that.
And somebody to pull the chair off from the last guy.
I forgot about that.
And besides, not even you would set that barn on fire.
Oh, how do you know that?
Because you didn't insure it first.
You know, she's right.
I want to speak to the editor.
Oh, jeez.
Here comes Mayor Fostick.
Which editor?
The no good. Liar. Blaspheming, scandalous creep with the big mouth!
Can you be more specific?
Hey, look, everybody. The man's gonna lead us in a Christmas carol. Everybody, deck the halls with brides and kickbacks.
La 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 la. Back it off! What's this here about me lying to my constituents?
I think he means you. I voted.
May I help you, Your Honor?
I demand that you print an apology. And in the very next issue, I will not be slandered in such a fashion.
Hey, next time we use cartoons.
Can't do it. Mayor's got them all on the payroll.
Yeah. Can I speak Bob in there now?
Oh yeah, sure, Bob. Bag this!
I'm not kidding around here, guards. Either you print an apology, or I take you to court, and we'll just see what the justice of the peace has to say. to say about this?
Who, you mean Judge Fosdick?
Your mother?
Nice little administration you got going there, man.
Max, this isn't an administration. It's a family reunion.
And what's this here about her being my latchkey? What's that mean, anyway?
It means she lets you in at night.
Hey, he was scratching at the door, and Mayor, it says, I'm your lackey, not your latchkey, of which I am neither.
I mean it, guards. You retract it, or we'll go see the judge. I can shot this rag of yours right now if you tangle with me.
I'm not worried. I've had my shots.
Guards, one more crack like that, and I'll get the GP over here.
Fat lot of good that'll do you. Who do you think told me all that stuff?
Yeah? Delbert told me that?
Are you going to answer all those kids' letters this year?
Just a second, bud.
Listen, man, why don't you get your facts straight before you come barging in here demanding things? We have a right to print whatever we see fits.
All the news that's print to fit.
I figure.
It's a right. It's called freedom of the depressed. Not that happened last night.
Is he going to answer all those kids' letters? The ones to Santa?
Sure, Barney. We'll get right on it.
Paul, you might want to take a look at this one. I found it back there. I don't know where it came from.
Do you mind? We're trying to do business here!
What, you got some more lies you want us to talk about?
I can't talk to him. It's a wonder his parents ever got married.
They got married?
Listen, Doc, I'm the mayor here, and that stands for something.
Yeah, it stands for plenty, providing no one else is looking. And don't you go waving that title around here. The office of the mayor is only as good as the person in the office. You can put a polecat in a house. That won't change it from being a polecat, but it'll sure make the palace stink. Hey, someone write that down.
I got it.
That's fine.
Well, that's it. From now on, I only speak to Channel 5.
Television news.
They get it first. They get it right. And they get it out immediately.
Oh, yeah, you might get a 5-second sound bite, 3 lines of copy, before they move on to any other 85 stories out there. They only serve the state of facts and speed of research.
I love this speech.
And you might get a film clip sandwiched in between two commercials for sandwich bags. They might actually print with you. What do you say? But they don't want to check for accuracy, mainly because they may cost you the legwork.
All the news that gives you fits.
Don't tell me you agree with him!
Well, hey there, partner. I was just passing through these parts.
Well, you better get on down to City Hall if you want that interview with the Lieutenant Governor. I'll deal with you later.
There goes Mayor Fosdick.
The Lieutenant Governor's in town, and we didn't get any notice.
My, look at the time.
You had us taken off the state press release list, didn't you? And that's why you wanted to send me on some wild, Christmas goose chase way outside of town.
Oh, he's just stopping by at my invitation. No big deal.
Your invitation?
Well, the mayor wrote him a note inviting him down to look at the new city hallway, but I wrote, Winona says hi on it.
New city hallway. Another great civic improvement. Half the streetlights are broken, but the mayor's in-laws have a place to play dominoes.
Well, I was coming over here to invite you.
Ooh, you came in here to pursue us.
Well, after that.
Oh, sure. Chief. What's this again? Dear Santa Claus, I hope you have time to read this. I don't. Didn't I give you your assignments?
Just waiting for the go-ahead.
Go ahead.
you don't even like the lieutenant governor.
I don't like any politicians.
And they don't like you.
Won't stop trying to cheer me up.
Hey, I'm in the same boat you are. We're a couple of weekly newspapers fighting to stay in business. Why, this town used to have 5 days. Now it's just down to us. Everyone seems hell-bent for leather to have their news force-fed to them through television or through computers. I wouldn't be surprised if in the next 20 years, it isn't intravenously fed to them by projecting holograms on their brains. And you, still using this old beat-up typewriter.
There will always be newspapers. We can go further in depth into each story, give more background, and we can... Why am I telling you all this? And as far as this old typewriter goes, yeah, I suppose it should be replaced. But it was a gift from Maya. Well, I guess you're right. It's as outdated as this reindeer. Just an image from the past with no functional use anymore.
It's a moose.
Is it? Hadn't you better get going? You don't want to miss your interview.
You're not coming?
Nah, I'll just make up something here.
I used to have one of these when I was a kid.
You used to have a moose?
Oh, not a moose exactly. At least I always saw it as a reindeer. Anyway, it was our family for years. We became our pushing one. Here.
What?
Oh, our wish market. You never had one of those? Oh. I guess there might have been some story Dad made up. But the legend goes, there's a certain Christmas ornament, usually an old one that's been around a while, and granted your fondest wishes. But only around Christmas time.
Like Aladdin's lamp?
Yeah, the only difference is I brought the moose from the mayor show.
About this letter.
Chief? Let's see it.
Look, we've got one more issue to get out before Christmas, right?
Yeah, day after tomorrow, Christmas Eve.
So it won't hurt if we bring up the same one from last year. Nothing's changed.
Just a little thing called the news. Right, JJ? JJ?
What's it say?
Listen to this. Dear Santa Claus, I hope you have time to read this. You might have heard by now that Papa died last month, and it was right after I done wrote you that letter asking for a bicycle. I don't want that bicycle no more on account of me needing other stuff anymore. We both miss Papa an awful lot, but Mama says you should have Christmas anyway. But I don't want you to come here on account of how you seem to put it. I guess I don't want... ever want Christmas again. It just won't be much the same as it used to be. Yours truly, Joey.
Oh my goodness. Joey who?
Didn't say. Barney, where did you get this?
It must have come in with that batch of kids' letters they borrowed from the post office. They didn't have an envelope.
Joey, there must be 100 kids around here named Joe. That poor little guy.
Hey, buddy, go next door to the post office, see if you can find the envelope. It's gotta be there.
Maybe it'll have a return address in it.
Or maybe there's some other way we could find that kid's name.
Then we could do something for him and his mom.
Yeah, I wish we could find him. I mean, we might be able to do something nice for his mama, but what would that be?
Well, I could go through our files from last month and find out who died.
Good idea. Delilah, go through our files. It's got to be there somewhere.
Oh, Lord. I just thought of something.
What?
Well, I used to call my parents Mother and Daddy.
Who?
So I used to call my grandparents Mama and Papa. What if the kid's talking about his grandfather?
Oh, just look. We're about to come up with something. But then comes the hard part.
Is...
How do you make a kid believe in Christmas again?
That's nice, Chief.
Oh. It just quickly had you head, as most likely to be visited by 3 ghosts on Christmas Eve.
what nice. It's just the angle I've been hunting for.
Bill, say, wait. Go through our files last month and find out who died.
No, no, we're not going to have anybody exhumed. You're just doing this for an angle.
What difference does it make why we're doing it if we can brighten up that kid's Christmas?
And sell a few hundred issues in the process.
That's all that matters.
What about doing it for the right reason?
Oh, you know the old saying, it's an ill wind that blows.
From the direction of your face.
We're looking for a man who died who has a son named Joe.
Oh, you two are worse than Barney and his wish moose.
His what?
Yeah, talk about your fairy tales. He says some old ornament with grand wishes at Christmas time.
And it's got to be a moose?
I'll be at the mayor's office with you.
Talk to Barney.
Right. Just call me.
Hey, that might make
Barney
a nice color piece.
Thanks.
Christmas wishes, tinsel and tall tales.
Bill's checking right now. Wish me. If I ever had a wish, it'd be to get that replacement crush for that ragged old desk for printer I'm forced to use.
That's still broken?
They quit making the parts right after the Civil War, I think. If we get some more equipment around here, what are you typing up?
Just a little side piece. What'd you find out?
Well, Phil's going through the files right now. This is such a sweet thing you're doing.
You take that back.
Huh? He's only doing it to sell mittens. He doesn't care about that kid. He doesn't care about Christmas. I don't think he cares about anything.
JJ, is that true?
Oh, listen to her. But she didn't think of it.
Why, you hypocritical old goat! He isn't listening to you. He doesn't listen to anyone.
Yeah, we keep telling him to go to the wizard and get a heart.
Hey, what do you think you're doing?
I thought you wanted to help that poor boy.
We will.
And not put it in your paper?
Wash your mouth out. What?
Here, make a wish on this.
Listen to me, Garnt. You try to play this thing up for profit, and I'll expose you in the Times.
Oh, like people believe your rag more than ours. Let's just try to help out the kid, worry about motives later.
Oh, sure. I just wish your mother knew what you were doing.
My mother? Oh, there's a threat. And this is Harold's property. Now let's get busy.
I know, happy shoppers.
Need a lift?
Working here? Always.
What's the big deal? You find the kid, get him a few things, he'll remember for the rest of his life. I'm sure that's all it will take. He just needs a little. I don't want that bicycle no more on account of we need other stuff for. We both miss Papa an awful lot.
They're going to the dead letter office right now. Except a lot of loops there. They'll bring it over.
Oh, great. What's that?
A package for Delilah. It's from Dexter's business. I think it's that new clutch for a printer.
A new clutch? That's amazing. She was just wishing. Hell Tribune, what? Mom? What made you call just now? We were just talking. Yeah. It's odd you should call right now. Okay.
Santa Claus is waiting for the bus.
You know what JJ was saying. Print them both and start an uproar over the new transit crisis. The high cost of Christmas. Slay or pay.
You still hanging on to that moose? Made any more wishes?
Oh, stop it. Still, it was kind of funny, you know, how I wished for that clutch and then out of nowhere.
Delilah, I'm telling you, no amount of wishing is going to change anything around here. That's just coincidence.
I guess. Still, wouldn't it be grand? Wouldn't it be the greatest thing?
How do you mean?
If you had a wish?
Oh, stop it.
I'm not saying anything's anything but a coincidence. But what if?
If I could wish for anything? Any responsibility. I guess it'd be Christmas. I wish I had more money to go shopping.
Oh, you're hopeless, you know that?
What? What did I do?
You could have wished for no more wars, goodwill towards all men, and peace on earth.
But no, a little more money for shopping.
All you wished for was a stupid old clutch.
I didn't know I was placing an order.
Well, if I get more money, then I'll wish for peace on earth.
And suppose you only get one wish.
You can tell me I only get one wish.
Hey, I didn't make up these rules.
Yes, you did.
All right, all right. Where'd we get this thing anyway?
I don't remember why.
Well, there should be seven others, right?
And you're yelling at me?
What?
You got one wish, Moose, and now you want seven more?
Well, not counting Rudolph.
Why is it they never count Rudolph?
I'm going to start a petition for impeachment. I'll get that big blowhard once and for all.
What, did you get the files?
No.
What files? Remember, we sent all our files over to the old city hall wing. Now that they have a new one, you know, for storage.
And his honor has confiscated them.
What?
Said he impounded them pending an investigation into information leaks in his administration.
Why, that lousy old.
You mean, just because of what we printed that his brother told us?
That's what he said. I told him. All I wanted to do was look in last month's obituaries, and he threatened to have me arrested.
You mean we can't find that kid, that Joey something?
Oh, great.
Maybe we can get rid of habeas corpus.
No, you need a dead body for that.
No, it's the other way around. You can't look for a dead body unless you have the writ.
No, can't ask for a writ unless you're looking for a dead body.
It's kind of like when JJ signs the checks for disappearing ink. Any news?
Oh, like we tell you.
You know what I mean. What are you all talking about?
Dead bodies.
And this is the holiday season.
Did you find anything out about the kid?
Didn't you?
The stinking man has impounded all our back issues. It's my own fault. Never should have put him over there in the first place. 3 months ago, he offered the space. So I figured, I'm going to open up channels. Turn over a new leaf.
We did turn over a new leaf. Last election.
And he was under it.
I'm getting old, I tell you. I don't see the curveballs coming anymore.
Did you find the kid?
No.
What?
And you go through all your last month's files?
We went through our files for the whole year. Nothing.
That's impossible.
That's what that blowhard meant.
What?
Well, the mayor promised the lieutenant governor that he'd start an investigation into payroll fraud. I wrote an editorial about it in our last issue. And anyway, he's using that excuse to hold on to your backlog?
You sure you didn't find anything in your files?
I just said I didn't. Just what are you implying?
Oh, nothing really. Just that I hand you the human interest story of the decade and we are competitors.
That's a horrible thing to say. Look, Horace Greedy. I said we didn't find anything. And I'm going to tell you again. We didn't find anything. JJ, can I ever lie to you?
No.
Well, thank you for that. Here, Sarah, here's something for you.
What's this?
Well, remember I used your photos of the September flooding? AP Wire picked them up and sent along payment for them.
You mean I get paid for my photographs?
I pay you for your photographs.
No. This is real money. And everything?
Hey, I'm starting to get my feelings hurt here.
It's called legal tender.
I know. I'm going to write a scathing editorial that's bound to get that Palmasol goat investigated.
Oh, good thinking. You've only been doing that in every issue of the Herald.
Oh, you're right. Maybe we could get him out of there.
You sure you want the IRS to know where you are?
Well, I'm off, Chief.
Oh, sure, Brian.
Where are you going?
Well, I got a couple of errands to run. First, though, I have to get over to City Hall and sweep up there.
Bobby, hold it!
What is it?
Just 2 seconds, fella. You wait right here.
Why?
Because I think you've been working too hard.
What's he talking about now?
He probably bought you a new room. What am I saying? He probably stole you a used room.
Brother, this is going to come in handy. I can't wait to go shopping and...
Holy smoke!
What?
It happened again! It came true! Your wish came true! What are you talking about?
Yeah, I nailed it. And I wished I'd get a raise so I could go shopping.
No, you didn't. Remember, your exact words were, I wish I made more money. And you did! What? Just moves. It's magical. Barney, tell her.
Oh, it's just sort of a Christmas fairy tale. You can apply it in any order, really. See, it grants your wishes.
Yes, and I wish for a new Dexter printer clutch, and I got it. And just a minute ago, Sarah wished for more money, and she got it.
Wow, that's just coincidences. It's got to
be. Probably, Miss Bertie, but, ain't that what this season's all about? Hope and faith?
Well, sure, but a moose?
Well, why not a moose? A rabbit's foot is for good luck, and so is a poorly hope. Why not a moose?
You ever been a salesman, Barney?
Sorry, I guess I just got carried away a bit.
Wait! Wasn't Garnes holding this thing yesterday when... Yeah, when he wished he could find that kid?
Oh yeah, I forgot about that.
Oh, we are still looking. Maybe there's no time limit on a wish. Maybe we can still find him.
Wait a minute, you really believe in this thing?
I'm just saying, you know, off the top of my head, you know, for the sake of argument.
Well, there's no time limits on faith. Only how's the chief going to keep looking?
Meet your new assistant.
Huh?
Just call me Clem. Sam, your old uncle, visiting down from the farm.
Do you believe this?
You show up like that and Fozzie will have you arrested. You watch.
What, for impersonating an uncle?
Why not? He's impersonating the mayor.
Buddy, you take care of the dust. I'll take care of the dirt. To City Hall.
I love this time of year.
On the first day of Christmas, my true love gave to me a partridge in a pear tree. On the second day of Christmas, my true love gave to me two turtle doves.
On the third day of Christmas, my true love gave to me three friend tries, two tackle shells, and a large rolls chicken chickpea. On the fourth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me four canned hams.
Oh, you like it? Okay.
Yeah. Four canned hams, three French fries, two tackle shells, and a large grilled chicken fricassee. On the fifth day of Christmas, my true love gave to me five onion rings.
Fuzzy!
When did you get here?
Well, somewhere between the soup and the nuts. Here in that old crop duster of yours.
Sure did. I got it over that field a couple blocks over. Hey, where is JJ?
Long story.
What delivery you bringing?
Well, he asked me to go find one, and I brought it in the back door. Just a second.
Wonder what he ordered.
Maybe he's gonna bomb City Hall.
Don't say that too loud. He should have been back by now, I would have thought.
Well, I think we sounded pretty good. I reckon we'll go out tomorrow night. Carolyn wants to go along.
Oh, going caroling? I haven't done that in years. But hey, we gotta have a name for ourselves. What do we call us?
What else? The Herald Angels.
Yeah, her. We sing.
I'm gonna wear a disguise. Seems like I spend more time over here than I do at my own newspaper.
I wonder why.
Shut up.
Where do you want this?
I don't believe it.
Christmas tree?
JJ ordered a Christmas tree. Come on over here.
Good. I hope he likes it.
JJ asked you to bring this?
Yep-er.
JJ Garns.
Got about this tall? Large pores. Sweats a lot. Nose like a pickle?
That's him. Well, you know, maybe he is getting into the Christmas spirit.
Wait a minute.
What?
Oh, don't bother her. She's thinking. I've seen this look before. It's a quiet, pensive attitude, reminiscent of a warthog caught in a tire.
I've got it.
Oh, this should be good.
Garns finds the kid, has him pose here in the office, in front of the tree.
For publicity shots.
Of course.
That'll tear their hearts out. All right, all right.
Hey, what are you talking about? What's going on here?
We're discussing a cynical, hypocritical con man with no heart.
What's JJ done this time?
Long story.
Well, I hope you write it, because JJ's stuff always makes me want to shoot the city council.
And mine doesn't?
How would we decorate this thing? We don't have any tinsel and lights.
Just as old wish moves.
You got a wish moose?
You know about the wish moose?
Are you sure you want to go there? That way lies madness.
Well, yeah. When I was a kid, there was always this certain idea that a Christmas doodad would
grant you a wish.
Yeah. Only we couldn't afford no wish moose like this. Makes you want to break down and cry, doesn't it? Poor little fuzzy, small child, runny no moose.
Where are all the other mooses coming from these days?
What do you call more than one moose?
Oh. I don't know. I find if you call one, that's really all you need.
Fuzzy, do you believe in that old story?
Well, sure I do. Well, yeah. Well, times. Well, no, not really. You ought to run. run for office with that kind of snappy comeback.
But the thing is, I wish for more money, and I got it. And Lila wished for a part for a printer, and she got it.
But that's about all. I haven't gotten anything I wanted, and I've held that thing as much as anybody.
Yeah, the last time you picked it up, you pointed it at JJ, and you said...
What?
Uh-oh. Remember, you said, as JJ was leaving with Barney, you pointed that at him, and you warned him that a warning's not the same as a wish, is it?
Look, whatever you say when you hold the thing, you said JJ would get arrested!
Oh, that's just silly. You don't for one minute think that what I said is gonna come true just because it's some old Christmas fantasy, do you? I mean, all I did was pick the thing up and turn around and point it at the door and say, JJ!
Merry Christmas! I'm hot!
What?
Keep that door locked, unless you've got your plane here.
Of a box over the field! JJ, what happened?
Foster tried to get me arrested. What do you think happened? Why are you all huddled around that moose?
Oh, jeez. Nobody here.
Hey, that's me, Barney.
Barney!
Anyone see you come in here?
Well, I don't think they're watching me, but they're bound to come over here. This is your neighbor.
Devils.
You realize we're going to have to be careful what we say around that thing from now on.
We're safe. We've already had our wishes.
That's it. We only get one wish, remember?
Hey, but it's like that old saying. Be careful what you wish for. You might just get it.
How did you get away?
Oh, the mayor said he wasn't going to arrest me.
Some loophole in the law?
Sort of. He said he didn't hate me.
Nothing really.
Fine.
He's charged with breaking and entering, obstructing justice, tampering with evidence, debasing public property, assaulted battery, and
mopery. What did you do?
Oh, it doesn't amount to anything. I got past the secretary with Barney. And just before I went into the old wing, I turned, and my mustache got caught on the hat rack. Just then Fossett came in, and the mustache came off.
Assault and battery?
I knocked Fossett down when I ran out of the window.
Oh, ran out of the window. This would make such a great story.
Oh, you would, wouldn't you?
Don't do that.
Fosick said he's going to hit me up with all those hot charges.
Well, that's why I heard a flying slattery over the phone as I was leaving. There might be more.
I gotta get out of here. Lay low till this blows over.
Did you get the files?
No. See what happens when you try to do something nice?
Oh, yeah. You were trying to get a hot story at the expense of some poor, sad child.
I was talking about me.
I'm telling you. You'll find that kid, JJ.
What are you talking about?
You wished you could find the kid, remember? Our wishes have come true. Yours will, too.
You can always hear the Looney Tunes theme playing, can't you?
JJ, we don't understand it either, but some of this stuff has come true.
And a kind of a couple of coincidences and some cheap Yuletide moves.
Look, you made your wish, it'll come true.
You're nuts. You gotta think of something quick. I just can't disappear here at Christmas. It's one of our busiest times.
I got my wish. Delilah got her wish. And Winona.
What?
Nothing. You didn't say nothing.
You're lying. I can tell. You're using double negatives.
Maybe if we get you into some other disguise.
Oh, right. Wait a minute. Winona, what did you wish for?
I didn't wish for anything. I just said that I was trying to warn you that...
That what?
Oh, you heard me.
All I heard was you yelling at me that I would get arrested. You dare say that to me with a loaded moose in the room?
Oh, you believe in it now, too?
I don't know what. I'm in the land now, thanks to you.
Chief, let me get you into something they never suspect.
Like what?
There's another change of clothes next week on that one.
I'll try anything. Just remember, if anyone asks, I join your monastery.
Well, you better hurry, Father Garn.
What's all the hurry? Slattery's slower than syrup, which isn't easy to say in cold weather.
You say all your wishes will come true?
Yeah, Barney. It's enough to make you pay.
Well, that's what it's there for.
Huh? Everybody, freeze!
If we stay like this, who's gonna feed us?
Oh. Barney, see who it is. We know he's clean.
Who is it?
Barney, is that you?
Yeah. Fiona?
Oh, hi. I was supposed to be fuzzy here.
Fiona, I'm so sorry. I totally forgot about you coming. Is this the bag of goodies?
Yep, it's all set for the drop.
Ooh, well, what's all this? Well, you know, since Garn's asked me to drop that Christmas tree off, I asked Fiona to meet me here. I didn't know I was going to be part of a lineup.
Hi, Fiona. This is the stuff for all the kids down at Purdy. You know how they love it this time of year.
Oh, I forgot. So old St. Nick's gonna fly over again like last year?
Yeah, you know it. Those kids love it. They get a kick out of it. Now, there's nothing breakable among those toys, is there?
All unbreakable and double wrapped.
This is so nice of the Civic Association.
Well, we do what we can. Good old Fuzzy does the rest.
Why do you drop the gifts? Why don't you just lay them? Well, I'll tell you, the kids don't really believe I'm Santy, even when I got the outfit on. But from a distance, I do all right.
Yeah, we can't find anybody to go up in the air with her. No offense, Fuzzy, but none of the men in town trust that old biplane ears.
Don't worry about it. The kids get the presents, and that's the main thing. Still, I wish they'd get a chance to actually meet old Santa.
Oh, I wish they could touch Santa.
Maybe we can do something about that.
Barney, you look.
I'm working on it. Here's the ball.
How do you drop that thing without hitting somebody?
Well, you know that old field on the edge of Purdy? Between that old chicken coop and barn. Used to be old man Durbin's place. Anyway, I make a couple swings on over, and then I dive down low, and I let her go.
That's why everything has to be unbreakable.
Well, I think I better get going.
Hold it a second.
Huh?
You're the one.
What? Did I rip something?
JJ can go with her.
Hey, good idea!
But how?
Excuse me.
Sergeant Slattery. Lovely day, isn't it?
Miss Persian, Merry Christmas. May the best of the Yuletide and all Glad Tidings come your way.
Makes you warm all over, doesn't he?
Oh, too sneakily. Is this the business belonging to one J.J. Garn?
Now you know it is.
I have a warrant for his arrest. May I inquire as to his whereabouts?
J.J.? Well, don't ask me. I'm his competition.
Miss Delilah, you must know where your employer is.
Who?
One J.J. Garn.
Well, you know, this time of year, he's out of pocket a lot. Spreading the cheer, helping the elderly, and
even I don't believe that. Need I remind you the penalties for aiding and abetting a fugitive of justice? Miss Sarah, I know you're not one given to lying.
JJ?
Where is he?
He's
Officer Slattery, can we get on with our distribution of gifts here?
Huh?
Our bag of gifts there. We're just about to make our annual drop over the curve.
That's right, Sergeant. I just brought this bag over to be delivered.
And I was just about to leave.
I suppose so. It's a wonderful and charitable thing you're doing for those unfortunate little types.
Doesn't he make you just want to hug him?
Go ahead.
Oh, I'm not going up.
Who is?
Merry Christmas! Ho, ho, ho!
Santa Claus is.
Who? Oh, finally got somebody to get in that flying tin Lizzie of yours. Huh, Buzzy?
Yeah. Hey, let's go, Santa.
Who are you?
He's an uncle of mine just off the farm. His name's Clark.
Oh.
Have you been a good little boy?
Hey!
Let's go, St. Nick!
Those kids are waiting. Right.
Hold it there. Just 1 minute.
Huh? What is it?
Forgot one. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas! Oh, and to all a good night.
Now, where's J.J. Garnes? And don't think you can try anything funny. I've got my eyes open, and I never miss a trick.
Well, once upon a time, there was a little boy who always wanted to be a policeman. Whenever he played cops and robbers, he always wanted to be the cop. No matter what the other kid said, that's all he ever wanted to be.
And don't think he's getting away with anything. I won't put up with it. I can take just so much. And my position has to put up with a lot, don't you know? And I do my best. And the people love me. They think I'm a sweetheart.
Probably a misprint.
They
think you're a sweatshirt.
Well, it was all I could do to get funding for the refurbishing of City Hall.
Yes, and that pool table's mighty nice, too.
Now, don't go changing the subject. Here the Lieutenant Governor pays our fair city a visit, and I have to have burglars. Now, how do you think that makes me look?
Like one of the community?
Look, Mayor, we've told you a dozen times. We have no idea where the boss is.
Yeah, you know how he is. He's probably flying off on some wild story or other.
I saw that.
Mayor, it's Christmas. And you said yourself that JJ didn't take anything.
And all he was after was our own files.
Yeah, I know. I've heard that song before. But I don't believe it, and I don't believe him, and I don't believe you.
And you voted for him?
Huh? Yeah, do you believe it?
What in the world? Is Buzzy still allowed to fly that thing around? I just know she ain't got a license for it. Well, I'll put a stop to that too when I can get around to it.
It's a good thing you haven't met Santa.
What do you mean by that?
Nothing, except he flies around in a sleigh, and I bet he doesn't have a license either.
Well, Slattery will pick him up. You can be sure of that. He's out combing the area right now.
For Santa Claus?
No, for Garnes. And when I get my hands on him, yes, yes or not, he's going to spend a lot of time on the prison newspaper.
We'll give him that lovely Yuletide message just as soon as we see him. He'll know exactly who it's from.
Am I leaving?
Well, you're just thinking that.
That what?
That how's Slattery going to report back to you if he can't find you?
Well, you're right, but Garnes has to get on an edition of that paper tomorrow, and we'll be back, and we'll nab him! Get out of my way!
Merry Christmas, man. Where
have you been? This is Chief Beck. I had to finish cleaning up the city hall, remember? Is the Chief Beck yet? I heard Buzzy fly over.
He should be here any minute.
What good will it do? As soon as he sets foot out of here, Slattery's gonna arrest him.
Only if they recognize him.
What do you think he's gonna do? Wear that Santa Claus outfit from now on?
Here they come! What in the world? Is the coast clear?
Yeah!
All right, it's the usual crowd. It's okay.
Well, you should have been there.
That's what it's all about, Chief.
Wait a minute. You liked giving something away?
Sure, he didn't show up for anything.
You got something, those kids. Something they hold dear. How to put the words. They're poor, most of them. Families live in hand to mouth. And yet they're sort of
hopeful?
That's it. That's what they got. Hope. You can see it in their faces. Something they hold and cherish. And as near as I can remember, they wanted to give me something. Oh, do you believe it? They don't have anything. They wanted to give me something.
They did. What's in the sack? Look.
Oh, my!
They each went to their tree and took an ornament off and gave it to Santy. This bag is full of them. And JJ, they wanted you to have them. They wanted you to put their ornaments on your tree.
Let me stick.
Yeah.
Here, am I not from the cops? Time to get another stupid story. Those kids. Those kids. Delilah, how much have we got in petty cash?
Huh?
Don't we have close to 400 in petty cash?
About that. You were saving it for bribes.
You take that money. You and Delilah, you go out to the store, buy up every toy you can find.
Right.
And I can get a hold of Fiona, see if they have any more they can part with.
Right.
Hey, what are you going to do here?
I'm going to need that plane again, Blessie.
For what?
Well, there's a lot of other little communities out there besides those that burn. And tomorrow, Christmas Eve, we fly over Hitchfield, Burdock, Murphy Station.
Oh, we'll take them all!
Right!
And I can start wrapping as soon as they get the toys over here. One thing we do have is lots of paper.
Right. Well, let's get moving!
On our way, Santa!
And bring a piece of roll. I'm going to need a seatbelt for that back seat. Come on, let's go.
Okay, who's in charge here? Here, I wrote this great article, and none of you appreciates it. Kind of hard to gloat in an empty room. Sergeant,
Miss Pershing, enjoyed your paper this morning. Really put the spirit of Christmas in me. Also enjoyed your caroling last night. Really tickled me. Ho, ho, ho.
Settle down, Slattery. You shouldn't go bouncing around the room like that this late in the day.
Sorry, guess it got carried away. Have you seen one of JJ's arms?
You still haven't found it?
No, but I have a lead. Rumor has it, he's in some sort of disguise. Say.
If you're gonna frisk me, go wash your hands.
Our rumor circulating is there's a cadre of citizens hiding him out.
A cadre of citizens? Who writes your stuff, Slattery?
I can't believe we finally got out that last edition. That's from all the running around.
That's right, Sergeant Slattery. I haven't seen Garns.
Huh? Sergeant Slattery?
Have either of you seen one J.J. Garn?
Why would anybody want more than one J.J.
Sorry, we've been busy getting off the Christmas edition of the Tribune.
Regret to have to do this, it being Christmas and all, but I have my duty to perform. I wish I didn't.
Maybe he should hold the moose.
That was really something about Santa visiting Purdy yesterday. Oh, I wrote a glowing article about it. I hope guards appreciates it.
Why would he appreciate it?
Oh, no reason. You know, us just being competitors and all, I like to think he likes to read my stuff. Anyway, we really got a lot of calls about it.
And I just heard that old St. Nick also paid a visit to several other communities today.
I know, but it was too late to get it in the paper.
It's gone! The wish moose! It's gone!
You're kidding!
Well, I can't believe you left that thing out of your sight!
It was right here! And I'm telling you, I'm starting to really believe in that thing.
Oh, yes, serious.
Look, I know three people who got their wish holding that thing.
What are we looking for?
It's a small Christmas ornament. A moose.
And it was right here?
Yeah.
I found that yesterday right here, and I put it in Santa Fe.
He did. I remember seeing him do it, but it just didn't register.
Wasn't it a toy for one of the furry kids?
I guess it is now.
You mean you really think it is magic?
I believe it. So sue me.
I keep telling you, all that was just coincidences. So what, I got that new clutch and you got that extra money. What are you talking about?
The wish moves, it's gone.
Well, the last time I remember seeing it was yesterday. I came over here and I held it up and said how I wish that kids in Fruity could actually meet Santa.
Wait, just 1 minute.
So nice of you to drop by, Sergeant.
Yeah, go ahead.
Shopping to do.
You know, some polish for your brass knuckles and, you know, a new whip for the little lady.
Hold it there. 1 second. Now I get it. Oh, it's you, Barney. Sorry.
Plan to take old Santa in, young man?
Barney!
Where's the, you know
who? He's, they want to know where I keep my reindeer. You know what? Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Comet.
Darn!
That was
fixed. We gotta stop him!
And do what?
She's right, we've been arrested for aiding and abetting.
Guys! Where's that stick in the grass?
Oh, Mayor! Mayor, how would you like to buy a couple of boats for the next?
Nice try, ladies. Do you think I'd stoop to buying boats?
Stoop? You'd have to get on a ladder.
I'm going to shut this paper down if it's the last thing I do.
Don't you believe in Christmas, Mayor?
Who are you supposed to be?
I told you you wouldn't recognize the suit.
Oh, I get it. Listen, if you think you can soften me up with some moth-eaten outfit...
This outfit stands for something. It stands for hope. It stands for fellowship and goodwill toward all men.
Bah! I ain't got time for this.
It stands for forgiveness. It's not just patches of felt and cotton and padding. It stands for the same thing that this time of year stands for. It's Christmas, Mayor. People smile for a change. People laugh and greet each other and look forward to the new year. And in here, there's happiness and joy. It's not vindictiveness, it's not adversity, and not revenge. The one time of year that people wear their hearts on their sleeve for a change. People sing carols and bright up their life with lights and holly and tinsel. A time when people give.
Do you believe this guy?
You used to believe in Christmas when you were a kid. You used to sing carols and play the organ at church.
Huh? How'd you know that?
Oh, I think I lost him.
I'm gonna fry you!
I gotta stop coming in here. Ooh.
Well, we ought to try to do something.
Like what?
Well, you could always try to trick the mayor in Slattery. And a happy Christmas to all!
And to all of the night!
You really love Christmas, don't you?
Can't you tell? It's what I live for.
Where are you going to spend Christmas party? You don't have any family here, do you?
Me? Why, but I have lots of family. And they're all out there. And Christmas, well, it's my chance to help on Santa Claus. We all do what we can.
Editor on the run! Thanks for holding the door, Barney!
Where did he go?
He went that way.
Oh, he went in there.
Oh, who are you talking about? Oh, Miss Bergier, you don't go worrying about me. I'm worried about you.
Me?
Are you going to spend another lonely Christmas like last year?
Oh, I wasn't all that lonely. I had my work and... How'd you know that? Didn't you start working here about the middle of the year?
I know he's here somewhere!
Yeah, but don't go in there!
He is so easy. I think I'm getting motion sickness. Oh, and you fly a plane? Oh, the plane!
Oh. You really like JJ, don't you?
Me? Why on earth would you say that? Arrogant, self-centered, undependable, irresponsible, and... How'd you know that?
Coming through! Hot food! Lady with a baby!
You can't run away from the law, darling, oh!
You sound like my last date! Oh, sorry. You know more than your calendar. You know that stuff about plastic and my last... I thought we were the investigative reporters here.
Oh, I just make a few things here and there.
Sure.
First, you say I'm a big elf.
Yeah, the large economy size.
Well, elves come in different sizes, you know, and Santa has lots of helpers. You believe that now, don't you?
Oh, sure.
That's important, Miss Pershing. You believe in the Christmas boots.
I didn't say any such thing.
And you believe in J.J. Garnes.
Oh, I don't know about that.
How is it I always end up in here?
You see him?
Yes, he's fleeting back. Haven't you caught him yet?
He can't get far unless...
But he's my plane!
Would you believe this? Everything is going to turn out all right.
Oh, sure. Here, Garnes does something for the first time in his life, and he's going to end up in jail, and the mayor wants to shut
his... And you've done something nice as well.
Me? What have I done?
Garnes is what is your only competition in the auto credit business. You should be happy about that.
Oh, shut up.
Any reason I shouldn't be in here?
Get going! If that plastic or that vinyl flat foot gets their hands on you...
I know. I've been thinking about that.
Well, you can think while you run!
Occupational hazard. You know, I'm not a young man anymore. I can barely clear a hedge now.
All this over some letter.
Which he didn't even publish.
Huh? But you did put it in the Herald? But I thought that was your angle. I thought you were only doing this for... JJ?
Don't you look at me like that.
You mean, you really did this to help that... poor kid and all those others out at Purdy?
It just didn't gel. The story didn't pan out. I made an editorial decision.
Yeah.
You know how it goes. You research a story, you follow all the leads, and if it doesn't...
Look, you did something decent. Now why not admit it?
Does your mother know you're here so much?
Where'd he go?
Out that way! Boy, if that doesn't shake your faith in sin.
You're a phony and you know it.
What are you talking about now?
Rough talk, city editor with no feelings. You're a great big fraud. You're as gooey on the inside as a caramel brownie.
Yeah, and you're a... You're a nut boss.
Chief, you better be going.
Here you are!
JJ, get out of here!
Fuzzy's warming up the plane. Come on, let's go!
JJ?
What's going on here? 1 minute they're running from the fuzz, and the next minute they're doing a tableau.
Don't you love this time of year?
JJ!
There he is, Larry!
Yes, sir. JJ Garnes, I have a warrant for your arrest.
JJ, you know, you have the prettiest blue eye.
You don't want to talk. I never noticed it before, but your eyes go on forever.
You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
How is it we never noticed all this before?
Just too stupid to see what was right in front of us.
Didn't take time for a personal life.
Never appreciated what we had.
You have the right to call your lawyer. If you do not have a lawyer, one will be appointed to you by the court.
You know, your hair, it's so beautiful the way it just falls like that.
I don't think we should be here today.
Don't fall for this! Guards, you're under arrest!
Oh, go away!
Well, I suppose I could come back later.
Come in! I'm through being bullied by you! Slattery! Do your duty!
No! You can't do this! Not today!
Slattery!
Go ahead!
What's going on here?
What's going on here? I'll tell you what's going on here! We caught him! We finally caught him!
Well, that's just wonderful!
Tell me about it!
What, are you applying some kind of award? Maybe give him a ceremony?
Huh?
Such generous spirit this time of year. I knew it wouldn't get past you.
Generous spirit?
Well, yeah. Think how much happiness he's brought to so many people.
No. This is J.J. Cox. You're confusing him with a human. Wait a minute. This is J.J. Garnes, isn't it?
Well, we've been flooded with phone calls all day long wanting to know who finally brought Christmas to the children. And just who was our Santa from the skies? I tell you, I haven't seen this town so excited about Christmas, and I don't know how.
We're arresting him.
What?
Shut up, I say!
How'd you ever think of it?
He put me in the plane.
Well, you both should be congratulated, and don't you look like
elf? Oh, I'm not him.
Exactly.
No, he's just a big elf.
You believe it now, don't you?
Yes, I really do.
Wait a minute. He's the Santa Claus that's been flying around and...
You don't have to pretend with me, Mayor. I know you were in on it the whole time.
Yeah, I've seen that film.
He has been in office a long time.
Lots of want a lot of you.
Yes, sir. The mayor was in on it the whole time.
I was! But we were just trying to keep that our little secret.
Why would you keep it a secret? Nobody over at City Hall suspects anything.
Well, it's like this.
Well, you pulled another one off, Chief.
Yeah, well, I just put my brace together and with my back up against the wall, I figured. I didn't do anything. You know it.
You did more than you know. Remember the children's faces and how they beamed up at you?
But I didn't deserve it.
Yes, you did.
No, I didn't, Barney. I didn't even follow through with what I set out to do in the first place.
Huh?
That kid, remember Joey something? Never did find him. Never showed him what Christmas was all about.
Yes, you did. He knows the true meaning of Christmas now.
Oh, how do you know that?
He knows more about Christmas than anybody. Take a look at this letter. Look hard.
I've read this 100 times. There's no last name, there's no address.
Still don't recognize it, do you? You wrote that letter. Joey J. Gardens. About 30 years ago.
Oh my God. I did write this. Right after my dad. Bonnie, how did you get this?
Well, don't you know? I'm just an old elf. You need Darkin. It's Christmas Eve, you know, and Buzzy's waiting.
Barney, wait a minute. It was you that told us about that moose. That it was... And it was, wasn't it?
Merry Christmas to all. And to all a good night.
And that's why we wanted to keep it all under wraps.
Nice story the way you tell it, Mayor.
So we ain't arresting him?
What a car! What a car! Get off!
Be a
sit
for re-election.
That's the way I figured it. I mean, wait, I didn't do it for political reasons. We have to think about the children.
Especially those of voting age.
And JJ, you carried this off all by yourself?
Oh yeah. I was working closely with the mayor here. Oh, and he's got another surprise for you.
I do?
Oh, I know we were keeping it a secret, Mayor, but you can tell him now, I think.
Oh, yeah. I thought of that. Oh, I'm too modest. Why don't you tell her?
Certainly. You know that new wing on City Hall? Maggie just told me he's turning it into a youth center.
Yay!
Place for all the kids to go and play games, just be together, have dances.
Now just wait a minute, yeah?
Oh, I know it was your idea, Mayor. But its time has come. And so has yours.
All wrapped up like a Christmas goose!
Which is what I think I just got.
Well, this is the best Christmas gift ever.
Oh, and we have Barney to thank for most of it.
Barney?
Oh, we have one wish, Moose.
Which we lost somewhere. No, wait. I was trying to tell you. It was one of the calls I got yesterday. I included in my article.
was left out of Santa's impromptu visit. One small boy, who chooses to remain nameless, said he got exactly what he wished for Christmas.
What?
He got the moose?
He could have wished for anything.
Hold on, what did he wish for?
Well, he'd always seen these pictures, and he wanted to go to Canada. And
what did he wish for?
What else? A toy moose.
And he got it?
Brother, did he ever?
So now, JJ, do you believe in old Saint Nick?
Yes, Virginia, there is a Santa Claus.
Thank you.
very much. I see some of my students. I see Aaron Young over there. I have students in the back who've been with me through this fall and been very supportive. I see other PAC members, church members, relatives. Here. Rosa Diggs, I see a lot of people. George Stewart in the back, Matthews, Schmidt, my pie baker. I think if there's one person I'd like to meet here, it's like the best cupcake maker in my entire world. So please keep her and her family in your prayers. Thank you very much.
Started and before